The Philippine House of Representatives forms a special committee on nuclear energy in response to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s energy agenda. Pangasinan 2nd District Representative Marco Wanco is tapped to head that panel. He now joins us live for a discussion on the matter. Hi, Congressman.
Hello. Good afternoon, Ron.
Hi, Congressman. Thank you very much for joining us.
Hello.
Congratulations. Yes, I can hear you, sir.
Yes.
Okay, congratulations on the post, but we do want to ask you, why is the House of Representatives giving special attention on nuclear energy, so much so that it's been given a special committee to look into it?
Well, maybe it's because nuclear is so unlike all the other energy sources. What makes it special is its huge energy density, which allows us to eliminate the great shipping infrastructure for fossil fuels. The energy density of uranium is millions of times larger than the most potent fossil fuels, so that every 1,000 megawatts of nuclear would allow us to avoid at least $600 million a year of coal or gas importation. That was before the Russians attacked Ukraine. Now that there's this war, the prices of fossil fuels have skyrocketed. So it's even more than that. In terms of physical volume, for 620 megawatts, the size of BNPP, we're talking about 51 Panamax, 50,000 ton ships every 18 months. If that were nuclear, it's one jeepney load once every 18 months, only one time every 18 months. So that goes to show the huge difference between nuclear energy and all the other energy sources. Nuclear is clean, yet it's reliable, unlike the other clean energies, which are not reliable. So there's a big, big difference between nuclear and all the other energies.
Congressman, the special committee that was formed, what will be its objectives? What can we expect from it?
Its objectives is to craft the bills, the laws that would enable the government to deploy nuclear as soon as possible to meet the country's energy needs. The administration will last for only 6 years, and so the groundwork has to be laid today, and the orders for new plants have to be laid today and in the coming years, so that after this administration, or even during the end of this administration, hopefully, we could actually see nuclear power generation doors opened in the country. The only potential for half-priced electricity in the Philippines is through nuclear power. I watched the clip earlier before you put me on, seeing Secretary Lotilia talk for the first time. He mentioned all these other alternate energy sources. All of those are unreliable. All of those are intermittent. All of those require gas as backup. So that's fossil fuels. And so if we go overboard with these energy sources, we will be committing our country to gas, fossil fuels, for at least another 40 years, because if you put the investment down, then you're stuck with that for at least 40 years until it's fully run down. So we need to really plan what we're going to do in the future. Let's not paint ourselves into a corner where the solution is unavailable because we've already filled up our capacity needs with a very expensive energy sector unreliable one.
Speaking of energy, Secretary Lotilia, in other reports, and it may not have been included in the sound bites in our report, but he did say that he is open to nuclear energy, but it didn't sound like it's going to be one of his priorities, or it is going to be one of his priorities.
Exactly.
Do you think there will be a problem with that?
Well, it needs to be debated and discussed. The conversation ought to proceed. The conversation has been suspended animation for over 36 years now. Now the entire world is opening up to nuclear. As recently as a few weeks ago, the European Union Parliament voted to include nuclear in its green energy taxonomy. So now financing is open to nuclear for trillions of euro. So maybe even the World Bank, maybe even the Asian Development Bank, which previously shunned nuclear, will be open to financing nuclear. So there's a sea change in the world as far as attitudes towards nuclear is concerned. If you want green, if you want clean, but you want reliable to remain, then you go nuclear, or you have a big part of nuclear in your energy mix.
Congressman,
that's where we're going.
I've seen other reports saying that there is a decline in the dependence of nuclear power in different countries, specifically that will be Germany and France, those countries who are dependent on it, because of the cost of putting it up. Putting up and maintaining plants. If ever we do go ahead with it, can the country afford it?
Definitely, especially in the Philippine context. The Philippine context is so different from that of Germany. And in fact, you are factually wrong about Germany and France. As we sit here, as I sit here discussing this with you, great debates in Germany about saving their last three nuclear plants and restarting the three nuclear plants that they shut down last year. Mm-hmm. Because the price of gas after the Russians invaded Ukraine in Germany are astronomical, and the German people can't seem to bear it anymore, including their economy is suffering. Macron has woken up to the realities of how good nuclear is for France. And so he has ordered the construction of the EPR2, which is their newest and biggest nuclear power plant, 1,600 megawatts each. I think he ordered 9 to be constructed. So your information, Paul, should be rechecked. I think there's a factual error in your reporting.
It's not our reporting, sir. It's just something I read, and you may be more correct because that report may have been published before Germany and France had a problem with their supply.
So in the Philippine context, no, we have no coal, we have no gas, so we have to freight in everything by ocean freight from overseas. During the Olympics, when China was madly scrambling for bottoms, they outbid us, and the cost of shipping for a brief moment exceeded the cost of the coal. And it's historical. You can see the blip in the price of electricity when that happened. Mm-hmm. So with nuclear, you eliminate the entire need for shipping, you know? So it enhances your energy security, fossil fuel independence, it enhances your national security. You cannot be blockaded anymore in the oceans because the entire inventory of fuel for 18 months sits inside your reactor. Mm-hmm. And it's such a small thing that, you know, a small 737 could easily deliver 3 to 5 years worth of nuclear fuel. So you cannot be hostage by militarily superior country.
Right. This conversation on nuclear energy that your special committee will be spearheading, will it include the revival of the Bataan Nuclear Power Plant?
Definitely. No? But as I said, In a privileged speech I delivered last week, Bataan Nuclear Power Plant is just a single plant of 620 megawatts, just a few percent of our Luzon grid. It can be felt if the energy in Morong will be given for free, which it can afford to do because it's much cheaper than coal or gas. But for us to feel the effects, the cheaper electricity from nuclear in the entire country, we need a fleet of nuclear power plants. Example is Korea, which started at the same time we did, more or less. Kori 2 is an identical copy of BNPP. They continued with their program. Now they have 24 running plants. They export nuclear power plants. They just finished four nuclear plants in the United Arab Emirates, an oil exporting country. Three are already running. The fourth one will run this year. They have half our population. Their per capita electricity consumption is 20 times greater than ours. It defines our poverty that, you know, we lost the economic opportunity to increase, I believe, anyway, our economy at least 1% of incremental increase for the last 36 years. That means our economy should be 36% larger than it is today. That's about 7 trillion pesos a year in economic opportunity loss that nobody ever talks about. Let's talk about it now. Mm-hmm. So we've given 36 years of chance for everybody to try everything else, and they've failed. Our electricity is still the most expensive in the region. So it has caused the Philippines to be avoided as an investment destination. And that's why we never achieved the two-digit economic growth rates our neighbors had during the Southeast Asian economic boom. And so we should learn from the past. Time to move forward. Mm-hmm. Nuclear is necessary.
Finally, Congressman, as you very well know, there are sectors who are opposed to the use of nuclear energy here in the country, primarily for their concerns about safety. Yes. Will their concerns be heard during the special committee's hearings and review?
Definitely. And my prayer is that they will also look at the historical facts, which show that nuclear is the safest technology ever, the safest industrial technology, generating technology ever invented by humankind, and that pollution causes mortality, and that if you have a nuclear plant anywhere, it is cleaner air and less pollution everywhere else, and less mortality, such that nuclear has already saved over 2 million lives in the world, and not having nuclear in the Philippines has already cost us thousands of lives in premature, shortened lifespans of our people because of pollution and emissions. So that's the other way of looking at it. So history proves nuclear safe. I hope that can be seen by these people who are the practitioners.
Congressman Mark Cuanco, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.